Michael Cleary with all his tips for footy, Tab, the rugby league. It is absolutely raining at Queanbeyan. And it's been raining in Victoria. The rain has got to Queanbeyan. Please, someone stop it before it gets to Sydney for the Golden Slipper tomorrow. Cosmic Eagle, the short-priced favourite for the third event at Queanbeyan. And here with his call is Tony Campbell.
But all the rage here is Cosmic Eagle, trained by Barbara Joseph. Was a good second at Albury. He's only had the two starts, this filly, by Eagle Eye. Eagle-eyed it is, the sire. But it looks like Boy Bluff giving the trouble over there at the moment. And Grand Supremo about to move along. Grand Supremo goes up in the purple and white colours. But Boy Bluff, a first starter by Bluffed, is the one that's holding up the start here. $1.60 now, Cosmic Eagle. $7.60 Tigger, $8.10 total coverage, $11 Grand Supremo and $12 Krithia. Krithia, another first starter, trained at Orange by Reg Priest. Jamie Whitney riding, and Krithia is a gelding, three-year-old by Senshire. But Boy Bluff is very, very obstinate over there behind the stalls. Second race taken out by Lovely Doreen, ridden by Adrian Late, who beat Prophecy. And Meetar was third. The winner scored by 3 1/4. A nose second and third. Now another effort made with Boy Bluff. They may have won the battle this time, I think. Caffrey stands up on the inside with Krithia, Cosmic Eagle. I think they've got Boy Bluff in now. This is the third event. Yes, starter coming around towards his dispatch point. For the Star City Maiden Handicap, 1,000 metres the journey. And they're boxed and ready. They're set. As the steady rain continues, Imorella stands up there set. Snowvale in the centre. The gates are ready to open now. They open now, and slowly away was Krithia. Caffrey didn't jump all that well. Our Valiant back third last and showing speed was Tigger out very wide. Now Cosmic Eagle is driving right up along the inside, followed by Imorella. In behind those total coverage, followed further back in the field, our Valiant gaining ground. Up on the outside was Boy Bluff, followed by Snowvale, Grand Supremo. Well back, Caffrey is second last, and at the tail of the field was Krithia. Inside the 600 as they race up towards the turn, and the two favourites, Cosmic Eagle on the inside, a better long neck in front of Tigger. 2 1/2 behind those third as they make the bend. Imorella followed then by total coverage and Boy Bluff up on the outside. Further back in the field was our Valiant, well back behind those Grand Supremo in the straight, racing down towards the 200 and shaken up the favourite. Cosmic Eagle is clear on the outside. Tigger's trying hard. Imorella down towards the inside is running on, and then total coverage. He's got to go for the whip on Cosmic Eagle. Tigger on the outside can't do much better. Cosmic Eagle holding on near the line. Tigger's diving. They hit the line. Oh, it's close. It's extremely close. Cosmic Eagle or Tigger, there's a nose in this. Imorella down on the inside, followed then by total coverage. Further back behind those Boy Bluff, then Snowvale, our Valiant, Grand Supremo, Caffrey, and the last one to pull up was Krithia. Well, it was home to the world, the favourite, but Tigger's dived on the outside and made it very, very close. Stand by. Now number 8 has got up here, Tigger. Number 8's the winner, Tigger on the outside, ridden by Raleigh Sexton. Beating number 7, Cosmic Eagle, was home to the world until the very last stride. And third was 11, and that was Imorella, ridden by Kevin Sweeney. So the numbers on the third event at Queanbeyan, 8, 7 and 10. 8 the winner, Tigger, trained by Brian Callaghan. Raleigh Sexton is a 2-year-old chestnut gelding by Zoffany out of Chain of Ponds, is raced by Mrs. M.A. Callaghan, Miss J.R. Baker, Miss D.M. Pryke, and ridden by Raleigh Sexton. Second, number 7, Cosmic Eagle by Eagle-Eyed out of Cuenta, trained by Barbara Joseph, John Scorse. And third was 11, Imorella, trained by Trevor McIlrick and ridden by Kevin Sweeney. So the numbers on the third, 8, 7, 11. Number 10 was fourth in the race, and that was total coverage. Now the time was 59.71. 7.30 and 2.10, Tigger. Tigger to return 7.30 and 2.10. Cosmic Eagle $1.10 and Imorella at $3 even. Well, Cosmic Eagle, as I said, looked home to the world, but right on the line, Tigger dived and got there by...
...on the outside, Masque's doing better, he races to Vain Dara, and Masque away, comes away, gives Jack Denham the Cronulla. Mask A by 2 lengths to Vane Denham.
Reliving some of the glories of past Golden Slippers. Tomorrow, Golden Slipper Day.
Is coming at purpose, but love a show, and here's Sir Dapper down the outside. Sir Dapper with a big lunging stride had raced up now to Been There. It's Sir Dapper, Been There, and love a show, but Sir Dapper forging away with a 1983 Golden Slipper. Sir Dapper beat Been There, love a show third.
Running on pretty well as desirable with Bianca and Romantic Dream late on the scene, but they won't get the Vafti. It's the Vafti's Golden Slippers. He's won by a length and a half.
That was Vivace winning the Golden Slipper in 1976. Some memorable winners of the Golden Slipper. The big question is, what's going to win tomorrow? Fates Gallant? Esk, River Stage beat Carrera and Mighty Alliance 6-3 and 2. Now at Queanbeyan, they're making a good line for the running of race 4. And it's Jungle at $3.10, West Texas at $5.40, Timely News at $6.30, Opening Scene $7.80, Princess Gorgeous $9.80, and Centaur's Fury a $10 chance. Now at Seymour, the upcoming race, now they've been decimated by late scratchings, 1, 2 and 3 and 4, all late scratchings. Tyson's Isle 350, He's Crafty 720, Stout $3, Miss Angelique $6.20, Cade $6.90, Lord Windia 28, and Brainwave 12. Waits right at Esk. Brian Blackmore at the late scratchings, he's left with one. It's number 5, Tyson's Isle. That's Brian Blackmore's lone selection for race 7 at Seymour. Set to go at Queanbeyan. Here's Tony Campbell.
The line is set. The rain has eased slightly, but still very dark over here. Oh, there's West Texas going off. Settles down again. Princess Gorgeous drawn the outside. Jungle is drawn wide. Tillamook the inside with Opening Scene and Centaur's Fury. Now Ramblin' Ruby getting a bit toey in the stalls. Now the starter walking away from his dispatch point here. The rider of Ramblin' Ruby is standing on the uprights and looks like Ramblin' Ruby has been taken out of the stalls. Kevin Sweeney, the rider. Ramblin' Ruby has been backed out. All the other runners are standing up quietly. Tillamook, the inside opening scene. Here's the chief steward. Hello. Ramblin' Ruby. Okay. So Ramblin' Ruby got a head down underneath the front gate and is undergoing a vet's examination. Ramblin' Ruby undergoes a vet's examination. She got a head down under the front gates of the stall. So Ramblin' Ruby is now going through a vet's examination over there behind the 1460 metre starting point. Yeah, light rain has been falling here consistently throughout the day. Now it looks as though Ramblin' Ruby has gone up again. Has she or not? Is she down behind that bush there? No, I don't think she's gone in as yet. Now the starter's on the two-way to the steward here. We should have some news regarding Ramblin' Ruby shortly. All the other runners are standing up. Centaur's Fury opening scene. Now here's the clerk of the course coming around to relay a message to the steward. Apparently the communications has broken down between the starter and the chief steward here. Now stand by, we should have an announcement regarding Ramblin' Ruby here shortly. Now Ramblin' Ruby is back behind the stalls. I'd say she's coming out, or well, stand by. Now here's the clerk of the course coming back to the enclosure. So whether we require a new piece of equipment or not, I'm not sure. The favourite on the tote here. Now stand by, here's the steward. Hello. Late scratching, 3:25, thank you. Late scratching, 3:25, please note, Ramblin' Ruby is out. A late scratching and they're racing now. Tillamook down on the inside got away well. Silver Gamble didn't jump all that well and showing speed opening Scene and Centaur's Fury. Out very wide from the outside gate, going up was Princess Gorgeous, followed further back behind those. Sense ahead, followed by Jungle. And very wide, West Texas is skirting the field. On settling down as they leave the side and race down the back, and Centaur's Fury on the inside has taken on and joined now by West Texas. They've got well clear, about three in front of opening Scene. Marinsky Miss, followed by Princess Gorgeous. In behind those in the field, down on the inside, Sense Ahead, followed by Jungle. A long break behind those, Don't Shoot Me, as they race down the back. A further break of about two, then Tillamook, followed by Timely Muse and Silver Gamble. As they race down the back, 750 metres to go, and West Texas goes to the lead, a length in front, Centre's Fury second. A length and a half, then opening Scene, running on well third. A long break behind those, Marinsky Miss, as they race up towards the turn, then Princess Gorgeous running on fairly well. A long break to Jungle, giving the leaders a big start, followed by Sense Ahead, and further back behind those towards the turn, Timely News, followed then by Don't Shoot Me and Tillamook as well back, but around the turn 350 metres to go, and West Texas down on the inside is the leader well clear. Opening Scene is running on fairly well, Centre's Fury followed by Princess Gorgeous, and a long break behind those, Jungle, and back behind those down on the inside, Marinsky Miss, but it's West Texas the leader getting tired. Here's Princess Gorgeous coming very quickly now, and down the outside, Timely News could beat them all. Out wide, Timely News and Princess Gorgeous, they're going to the line. Timely News hit the lead to the line, and Timely News. Timely News first. Now close for second, Jungle or Princess Gorgeous. Then Centaur's Fury, Don't Shoot Me, then Tillamook. In behind those, West Texas, followed by Marinsky Miss, opening Scene well back, Silver Gamble, and the last one to pull up was Sense Ahead. So the winner is Timely News, written by Michael Ward here. Number four, the winner, Timely News, written by Michael Ward. Trained by Mick Smith at Queanbeyan, 6.40 on the tote for the win, and $2 even for the place. Now number two, Princess Gorgeous is second, written by Larry Mortell. And number one, Jungle third, written by Ellen Abrahams. So the numbers are up very quickly, 4-2-1 for the winner. Timely News, a brown mare five by Newley out of Trying Times, trained by Mick Smith at Queanbeyan, Michael Ward, and the winner raced by MW and Mrs. M.A. Smith in partnership. Second goes to Princess Gorgeous, a bay mare four, Select Prince out of Snowing, trained by Bernie Connell, Maruya, Larry Mortell, and Jungle third, a Chestnut Gelding three, Jade Hunter, Jasmine Garden, Daryl Rolfe, Ellen Abrahams.
Yeah, nice strong win there to Timely News with Michael Ward in the saddle. It's coming very strongly on the outside now to move up and claim them. And did get home very, very hard. And nice win. Now that rain there at Queanbeyan, which cause the track downgrade, and just repeating that late scratching from the fourth, number 10, Ramblin' Ruby. So you get your money back on that. And it's starting to become overcast in Sydney, which is a bit of a worry for tomorrow's Golden Slipper Stakes. $2.5 million worth. And goodness knows what the horses are worth. Still shaping up to be an exciting affair, the Golden Slipper. In the meantime, we're going to try and build.
I'm Scarlet. John Taper River is hanging on strongly at the half furlong. I can't get the win, I'm Scarlet, nor can Sovereign Slipper. And the grey is going to make racing history. John Taper goes on and wins the Golden Slipper, a length and a quarter to I'm Scarlet, a length and a half away.
Stop the rain from falling if you ask me to. I'd do anything for you. Your wish is my command. I could move a mountain when you're
to Royal Troubadour. Inspired Clear now. Love a Kiss is going out after Inspired, but Inspired Clear from Royal Troubadour. And Inspired wins the Golden Slipper. I'd say Love a Kiss.
You better be home soon.
There he is, a baby-faced Darren Beedman, one of two apprentices to be successful in the Golden Slipper. This is going to be an interesting call. He cannot see. Mind you, Tony, I've been out a few nights and ended up blind. But at Queanbeyan, it's timely news. Jungle and Princess Gorgeous, Quinellas and Trifectas on the fourth event at Queanbeyan. That, of course, is after the protest was upheld, third against second, 4-1-2. Well, there you go. Now you know how people who drink sometimes look at the world. Twilight Greyhounds chime in 3 minutes. Cranbourne, race one. Medallia Star, $5.50. Tobin Hill, $5.20. Central Bay, $5.50. Sharp Shiraz, 11.
Moving in at the 1200 now. I think they're all in. They're all in. Starter coming around to release the field.
Right at Queanbeyan, this is race five. Let's go to Tony Campbell.
Very kind of you. Now they're all in here and they're very, very difficult to see. As the gentleman said, life wasn't meant to be easy. And away they go. Now, Goldstein was last out of the gates, and Miss Hepburn got away on the inside, and Jetline is prominent. Not too far away was, behind those settling down, was Quick Steel. Now, let's sort themselves out as they race inside the 1,000. Now, Lockyer going very quickly, leads Quick Steel, followed then by Jetliner down on the inside. There's another one up there. It looks like Royal Spectre. Now, Miss Hepburn is behind that group as they race down the back. Further back behind those, Goldstein, I can tell you as well back. Up ahead of Goldstein was Henry Seen, and Like a Genie as back towards the tail of the field. But Lockyer's flying. Lockyer's flying as they race up towards the turn. Out about five or six in front of Royal Spectre, followed then by Quick Steel. Down on the inside, Jetliner. Further back to Miss Hepburn. Then A Little Dream, and going around the field, Like a Genie, followed by Goldstein and Henry Seen as well back on the turn. But Lockyer is a mile out in front at the top of the straight. Out about four or five in front of Royal Spectre, then Jetliner. Now down on the inside, Miss Hepburn is running on, and on the outside fence, Like a Genie, and Goldstein is putting in a run, but still it's Lockyer. Lockyer the leader. Miss Hepburn down on the inside is running on fairly well, but Lockyer will clear. Now Jetliner's flying near the line, and Miss Hepburn, but Lockyer out wide on the track. Lockyer's the winner. Now close for the Miners, Jetliner or Miss Hepburn. Out wide, Goldstein. Further out then, Like a Genie, followed back behind those, Royal Spectre, then Quick Steel, A Little Dream, and Henry Seen. And is there any more? I don't think so.
Well, Peter Malin squared up on Lockyer. It was the one that tipped him off in the mounting yard, and he just sooled it out of the boxes and said, do a bit of work. And he travelled deep all the way. $15.50 and $3.80 for Lockyer. Number one, Jetliner, $1.70, and number four, Hepburn, $1.90.
10-1-4. 15.50 for the win. 10-1-4 the numbers. Number 10, the winner, Lockyer, trained by Fabian Azzopardi, ridden by Peter Malin. A two-year-old gelding by Sportsworks out of Red Pouch, raced by FC Azzopardi and A. Smith. Now, number one, second, Jetliner, Scott Pollard for Catherine Brax. And four is third, Miss Hepburn, Brett Johnson for Amanda Langler. 10-1-4. 1-12-94 was the time. 1-12-94. And the numbers here are 10, 1 and 4. 10, the winner, Lockyer, ridden by Peter Malin, beating one, Jetliner, Scott Pollard, and four, Miss Hepburn, Brett Johnson, third. Fourth was number two, and that was Royal Spectre. We'll have the margins in a moment. A long head by a head, the margins here, a long head by a head. A long head by a head, the margins, Goldman. Queanbeyan, where am I? Queanbeyan. Make it quick. Set to go. 10-1-4 the numbers. 10-1-4, 2 and 3. A long head by a head. I'll have the totes when you need them, Greg. Now the runners back in the enclosure following the running of the Gecko Gang Class 1. Lockyer holding on to score by a long head with a head between second and third. Lockyer, Peter Millin first, Jetliner, Scott Pollard second, and Miss Hepburn, Brett Johnson third.
Betting four, race six, and number four, Help, at $3.90. Number one, Go With Dancers, $4.10. Number five, Welliswood, $8.10. Number three, Potomac Mills, $8.70. Number two, Something Old, $9. And number nine, Shecky, $9.90. Starting to go into the barrier at Queanbeyan. We have another link problem with Supertab today. So we've only got Queensland and New South Wales totes at this stage at Esk. Race 7, Ilumba, Tontour, Miss Excelsior with the Quinellas and Trifectas. Hope to get Supertab soon. Cranbourne, Race 3, the Greyhounds. Murray Bree, 14. Kingston Jewel, $8.10. Bagman is $6.90. Rosie Portrait, $9.30. The favourite is number 7, Choice Shiraz at $1.70. Number 7, the favourite. Not surprisingly, a very talented musician, Patrick Anthony Campbell. He's gone for number one, Go With Dancers. Here he is, race six.
Now, Go With Dancers down on the inside got away well, and Spirit of the West is prominent. Out wide, Shecky is going up. In behind those, Potomac Mills, Something Old. Wide out, Help is looking for the lead. And also, My Mimi, there's a charge for the lead in the sixth event of the day. And as they race up the side towards the back, the one going around them was Help. Help is the leader now, draws out about a long head in front of Shecky second. Then Go With Dancers, followed then by Eternal Dawn, it looks like, on the outside. It is, in fact, back behind those Spirit of the West, followed then by Potomac Mills, who's down on the inside as they race down the back. My Mimi's up on the outside. A long break behind those then came Something Old, and dropping out to last was Welliswood in the back stretch as they race down the back, and Help has raced away with the lead. It's Help, a big leader, running second. Down on the inside was Shecky, up on its outside Eternal Dawn. In behind those, gaining a bit of ground, was Go With Dancers, followed off the track, Roses Are Blue. In between those, Spirit of the West, followed then by My Mimi as they race up towards the side of the track now, and Potomac Mills as well back, and we can't go back any further as they leave the back and race up the side, and still the leader was Help. Now Roses Are Blue on the outside is running on. Back behind those, Go With Dancers, followed by Shecky, then Spirit of the West further back in the field as they race towards the turn. There was My Mimi well back on the bend, but around the turn, and Help is a big leader, kicked right away at the top of the straight. Help out about five or six in front. Shecky's down on the inside, out towards the centre. Roses Are Blue, followed then by Eternal Dawn, then Go With Dancers and Spirit of the West down the outside, but it's still Help the leader. Help leads about two or three in front. Roses Are Blue, followed by Go With Dancers, out very wide Spirit of the West, but it's all Help, and Help races away. Help wins it easily. Help first, now Go With Dancers second, Spirit of the West third, then Roses Are Blue, followed by Shecky, Welliswood, then Eternal Dawn, back behind those Potomac Mills, My Mimi, and Something Old was last.
Well, it romped in, didn't it? Number four, Help, Johnny Nisbet, the rider. It's going to pay $4.60 and $1.90 as the Greyhounds parade at Cranbourne. Number one, Go With Dancers, a game effort, $1.90. And number 10, Spirit of the West, adding had at... Tony Campbell will be able to slip into a couple of Chardonnays. So race seven has been abandoned at Cranbourne. They did well to get the other six on. Clarindai, race 8 in 5 minutes. Gallic Chief, $3.30. Cool Chick,